In the single leg with dynamic lower extremity movement level 3, you're going to do 3 positions. You're going to do that forward motion that you saw first, then that backward, then the side, then the posterior lateral, then the posterior medial. Let's show them one more time. So anterior motion with the knee straight, backward motion, and then to the side, and then posterior lateral, and then posterior medial. Now let's look at the details and break this down so that you can do this exercise perfectly. First, on the support leg, which in this case is going to be the right leg, you want a 20 degree bend. It's also extremely important that this foot here is facing directly forward. The knee or patella tendon specifically should be in line with the second and third toe. Once the client pulls the leg off of the ground, what will happen is impossible not to happen is that the pelvis and the body will actually shift a little bit, just a little bit, because it has to have this foot near center to balance this structure. But with that being said, you want to fight and keep this acetabulum or hip joint as close to perfectly aligned with the patella tendon as you possibly can. Extremely important. So let's show it the best you can with that, Matt. Awesome. Without putting that foot down. Let's keep that left foot far off the ground for now. And let's show them compensation. Yes. Yeah, so oftentimes people will do this exercise and exercises like this on a single leg with this motion where it shifted, and we would call that a Trendelenburg. So that's a movement compensation. We don't want that. We want to be as stable as we can possibly be there. Now, coming up the kinetic chain, we want to make sure that the pelvis stays neutral, both sagittally and frontally, as much as you possibly can. It just needs to stay perfectly neutral, sagittally, perfectly neutral in the frontal plane without these shifts. So then we want the spine upright, aligned, slight arch in the lower back, chest upright, little cervical lordotic curve there. Good, let's hit the motion. So as we come in to this motion, you're gonna keep that knee straight, you're gonna go as far as you can without compensating into a posterior pelvic tilt in the pelvis. And then go ahead and rest, Matt. So when that leg comes up, what commonly happens and is improper is the pelvis will rotate under as the leg comes up. You don't want that. You want to just keep that pelvis neutral. Okay, let's show the second position of 5. 5 total motions in the floating leg there. You want to reach back as far as you possibly can with that leg, but most importantly, keeping a neutral pelvis. Then, bringing back to neutral position, let's reach out to the side. When you go to that side position, again, pelvis stays solid, isometrically aligned. Come back to the center, reaching posterior lateral, a little more lateral, more. Perfect. Good. Pelvis stays centered, both sagittally and frontally. Then, the trickiest position is that posterior medial. You're going to reach as far as you can, but you're not going to let that pelvis compensate and do a corkscrew motion. You're going to keep that pelvis neutral, but reach as far as you can. So that pelvic alignment, go ahead and rest, is always primary. If you think about it like that in your mind, pelvic motion is primary and stability of that, the pelvis is primary. Then secondary is all these leg motions. If you think about it like that, you're gonna do awesome with this exercise. And finally, let's just show you so you have an idea. Matt, if we were to do this just with performance, how would it look? This is how generally people exercise, right? They try to do the motion, and it's not about the alignment and biomechanical optimization of the body, but it's about just getting the full motion. That's not what you want to do. What Matt just showed you is wrong because of all those pelvic compensations. Keep it aligned, keep the pelvis aligned, and you'll have perfect execution on this exercise. The other thing to consider is this exercise is not only awesome for glute medius stability and creating a kinetic chain stabilization from single leg, which most all sports are relying upon, but strengthening that entire kinetic chain. We're strengthening intrinsic musculature in the foot. We're strengthening the lower leg musculature and stabilization, the peroneals, the anterior tibiala, everything coming up through the leg. All these hip musculature, pelvic muscles, pelvic floor muscles, because we're doing a transverse abdominal contraction. We got all that going on in this exercise. Tremendous benefits from this.